New York is that there's always something to do. There's always someone to meet. There's always something going on, and there's so much life, and it truly is a melting pot. There's so many things moshing and boshing together. I'm from upstate New York, but moving to Manhattan really brought to light so many different things and cultures and people and music and art, and there's just so much here. I just love it. Answer the Call is something that's never going to leave what's important to me, because I come from a long line of first responders. So my dad was a New York City firefighter. My brother is currently a New York City cop. My grandfather was also a New York City firefighter. First responders, firefighters, police officers, all those things are going to be in our lives for a long time, and mine personally for a very long time.
I can honestly say I've never once felt unsafe in New York City. I've been here for almost 10 years. That's a real testament to what these people do, you know what I mean? On our show on Billions, a lot of the Teamsters, the guys that drive all the trucks, pick us up, drop us off, get everything organized, a lot of them are ex-cops. And they're the best, you know, salt of the earth people. It's wonderful.
I realize when I work in this city how important it is to know that you're safe, and the sacrifices that these people make, these men and women make, to make us safe every single day.
Answer the Call is something that means a lot to me. I come from a family of firefighters. And unfortunately, guys that I've known have passed away in the line of duty. And even just recently, firefighter Chris Slutman, who worked with my dad for years, passed away. And I see firsthand how important it is to keep this going and keep making it better and bigger each year.
Not only did they lose a loved one, but they lost someone that meant so much to them, even financially, right? I mean, not only did their father pass away in a fire or police, but now that income is lost too. They want the support system of knowing that they can still move on as a family. They grieve, but they also need to know that they can be financially secure and safe and sound, and that's very important.
We believe that when a first responder makes the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty, it is our responsibility to be there for the families they leave behind. Our goal is to be able to raise enough funds to provide meaningful financial assistance for the rest of these families' lives.
I think one of the reasons why this night and nights like this are so important is that we have the responsibility to remember and never forget, and to do what's necessary to support the families that so tragically lost their loved ones.
It's important to know we're all supported in some way by a first responder. And it's not just those moments of crisis that make headlines that we hear a lot about. It's also every moment in between that they protect us and they keep us safe. I think tonight is a night for us to turn the spotlight around on them and to say we support them just as much as they have our backs every single day in this city, and that we will say, just as they say every day before they go to work in the morning, that we are proud to answer the call.
My name is Emily DiDonato, and I am proud to answer the call.
My name is Ryan Mara. I'm happy to answer the call.
My name is Don LaGreca, and I'm proud to answer the call.
My name is Toby Leonard Moore, and I'm proud to be here to answer the call. I hope you'll join me.